頭先大家聽到我哋建呢個殿建咗幾多年啊？長定短啊？相當長。你知唔知我哋有阿啟源弟兄啦？幫手建殿，佢係我哋即係好忠心嘅弟兄，一路幫我哋搞呢啲基建工程。佢話佢嘅頭髮咧係由唔係咁白，變到五年之後咧係全白。我哋將榮耀歸俾神。你知唔知點解要建五年咁耐啊？好嘅嘢係點啊？梗係耐噶啦，唔通可以一年就建好咁榮耀嘅殿出嚟咩？所以神係話俾我哋知咧，建五年咧係一個好珍貴、珍貴嘅一個殿。所以今日呈現呢個殿喺我哋中間咧，我哋真係要存好感恩嘅心，亦都咧要好珍惜佢，係咪啊？我頭先咧都聽到鳳兒咧同大家講。我哋有好多方面嘅提升，系咪啊？十三周年嘅口号系乜嘢啊？我哋一齐嚟做好嘛？增战得胜，全面提升，阿 Man， 全面提升咧，真系好多方面噶。我谂咧，我哋应该每个星期咧都讲少少，边方面提升，边方面提升，好唔好啊？咁呢方面咧，我哋頭先咧就係我哋頭先咧請族長同工上嚟感恩，我哋咧希望咧下個星期咧可以讓小組長上嚟感恩，再下個禮拜我哋請我哋嘅弟兄姊妹上嚟感恩。我哋希望咧呢度咧不斷不斷感恩嘅流充滿整個嘅聖殿，讓感恩嘅祭喺呢度獻上。第二個咧，我想同大家講咧，我哋有而家嘅扶手電梯咧，啱啱早兩日咧已經開翻嚇，咁咧我好想咧邀請弟兄姊妹咧，盡量用扶手電梯或者咧用樓梯出入，好唔好啊？咁大家咧可能有啲都唔知道我哋扶手電梯開翻添，今朝弟兄姊妹咧有啲仲喺度搭 lift， 咁我同佢講，你哋知唔知電動扶手樓梯已經開翻？佢話唔知道，咁所以咧我要喺度同大家講咧，已經開咗啦，並且貼咗好靚。好靓嘅金句，同埋咧呢一个墙壁嘅画咧喺上边，我哋将荣耀归俾神。咁并且咧，让呢一啲咧虽唔系好方便行楼梯嘅长者啦，或者系真系需要落去搭去停车场嘅弟兄姊妹咧，先至用个 lift， 好唔好啊？咁让我哋嘅人流咧更好。咁咧曾经有人同我哋反映咧，就系六一一咧聚会时间咧，你知唔知好似乜嘢啊？他話：我哋好似六一一，好似冇掩雞籠咁樣噶，啲人咧自出自入，中意幾時出幾時入都得噶，係咪咁噶？我諗下，都係嘅，又真係。咁我哋咧又係好想咧比較咧自由啲，我哋唔想咧太多嘅限制啊加諸喺弟兄姊妹嘅身上。嚟到六一一咧，我哋成日都標榜我哋要好自由、好喜樂。咁但係咧，我哋咧。都有啲嘅調整同提升，希望咧大家咧真係喺咁樣嘅氣氛之下咧，亦唔會覺得被好似約束嚇。咁我哋咧就係希望喺敬拜咗之後咧，我哋呢兩個大門咧以後都係會閂咗噶啦，好唔好啊？請大家咧由側門而入，並且如果你入嚟嘅時候咧，盡量坐到去中間，中間就係呢一度，好唔好啊？咁咧就。減少咧喺度敬拜同埋聽到嘅弟兄姊妹嘅騷擾，好唔好啊？好嘅，舉手俾我睇下。哈利路亞，六一一果然係一支軍隊嚟噶，非常之信服噶，感謝主。
好多謝師母，我哋要感恩一樣嘢咧，係我哋嘅樓頂未拆呢個房頂之前咧，同現在咧係高咗一米嘅，係政府批准我哋將個樓咧。那個屋頂升高一米，是不是值得感恩啊？哇，即一米就是有這個的講台，即是這裡這麼高的了、啊、我們感謝神。好，現在我要邀請我們今日的講員 Pastor Eastman、Dick Eastman 在我們當中、他是 EHC， 就是這個的逐家文字報道會的、Director，他們的office遍佈全世界，我相信有幾百間以上，他們也都是做全世界的，即是逐家的報道的工作。我們很感謝神， 有这个机构去帮助教会一起去传福音，并且他们都是我们所支持的机构来的。我们盼望他们可以更多来香港，更多祝福我们，甚至他们将来的服事更多的有我们份。我们用热烈的掌声来欢迎 Pastor Dick Eastman。
Good morning everyone。
大家早晨，大家早。
Are you happy？
今天大家开心吗？
Who's the happiest Christian here？
谁是最开心的基督徒？
Ah, the joy of the Lord is our strength.
主的喜乐是我们的力量。
And it is a joy for my wife and I to be with you today.
那我今天很高兴，我和我太太跟大家可以在一起。
My wife is here in the front row. She can stand up. And
我的太太，请大家欢迎她。
This year,
今年
my wife and I have been married.
我跟我的师母结婚
100 years.
100年。
That's 50 years each. 50 years.
因为我对我五十年，对他五十年，所以加起来就100年。
And we started in the ministry immediately, so it's also 50 years of ministry.
因为我们结婚马上就开始我们的服事，所以我们的服事事工也是五十年，就一百年。
And now we have a wonderful staff of more than 4,000 workers all over the world.
那现在我们在世界各地总共有4000个员工，就同工。
And every month, more than 40,000 volunteers help us take the gospel home by home.
每个月我们有四万个义工来帮忙，就是把福音给到传到每个家庭。
But this is a special occasion for us.
那今天是对我们来说一个很特别的时机。
Coming into this new sanctuary.
因为就今天我们来到这么美的殿堂里面。
And so when I knew that I was going to be here, I asked the Lord what I should share this morning.
所以当我知道我要来到大家当中的时候，我就求问神，神，我要到底分享什么呢？
He immediately brought to my attention something that happened in my life years ago.
他马上让我回想起我生命中曾经有过的一段经历。
And it gives to me this title for my message.
然后就让我给我的信息取了一个名字。
Make room for my glory.
为我的荣耀预备地方。
And I share from my heart that I believe this is the key, the most important thing I could share about the vision of 611 Church.
那我心里真的这样相信，这是神给611的一篇信息。
Because this is a new beginning.
因为对你来说，这真是新的开始。
Of greater things than we ever could have imagined before.
而是我们有史以来从没有想象到的事情。
There are many, many people yet to be saved.
也还有很多需要救恩的人。
And why do we win them for Jesus?
那我们为什么要为主来赢取灵魂呢？
Not only so they will be in eternity instead of, in heaven instead of apart from God.
那问题不是就是让他们上天堂，然后跟神一起，将来不下地狱。
But because when we win someone to Jesus, they are an eternal worshiper to give more glory to Jesus.
原因就是当我们为主赢得灵魂的时候，他们成为永恒的敬拜者，让神的荣耀领导。
And when I came into this beautiful place,
当我来到这么美的殿堂里面，
I knew the Lord had put this message on my heart.
我知道神把这篇信息放在我心里面。
Because I want to take you back in time.
因为我想把大家带回到之前历史上一刻。
To the most beautiful, extravagant temple ever built for the glory of God.
就是在历史当中从来没有个如此雄伟奢华的殿堂是为着神建造的。
And it was Solomon's temple.
就是所罗门的圣殿。
And I want to take you back to begin with one verse of scripture.
那我要把大家带回到历史那一刻，就是圣经里面所记载的。
It is 2 Chronicles chapter 5 verse 1.
就是历代志下第五章。
And I just read you this one verse to begin.
我首先为大家念出一节的经文。
It says, when all the work Solomon had done for the temple of the Lord was finished,
所罗门做完了耶和华殿的一切工。
Now we are in a beautiful building that's now finished here.
我们现在坐在一个新殿里面，这个新殿建好了。
It says he, Solomon, brought in the things his father David had dedicated.
他就说所罗门就把他父大卫分别为圣的物件带来。
And I emphasize the word things. Many things are in a building.
就是说在这个所罗门殿里面有很多物件。
It says the silver and the gold and all the furnishings, they were brought in.
这物件就是说分别为圣的金银和器皿。
And he, Solomon, placed them in the treasuries of God's temple.
然后所罗门王把这些物件放在神殿的府库里。
Now often we read our Bibles and we just skip over passages easily.
很容易我们读圣经的时候很容易就略过这些经文。
Because we are not fully certain of their significance to us.
因为我们不明白这一句话里面的重要性对我们的意义。
And so we just read about Solomon bringing in things.
所以我们就可能读到，哦，所罗门把这些物件都放在府库里。
And we may not know what that means.
我们根本就不明白里面到底讲什么。
So for a few minutes,
所以我要花几分钟。
I want to show you what the treasures of the house of God really were.
跟大家来讲讲这个圣殿里面到底放了什么宝物。
And the lesson that's in this chapter.
然后其他就记载在这一章里面。
And then I want to share a personal experience that was rather unusual for me.
然后我再跟大家来分享对我一个很特别的经历。
Where God showed me what he meant in this passage.
就是神怎么让我经历到他这段经文所讲的。
Now, about 90 years ago in America.
那我要跟大家19年前在美国。
There was a group of architects who were a part of a society in one of our states in America.
他们是在我们所住的州伊利诺州里面的一个建筑师的学会。
And they were reading all the passages of Scripture about Solomon's temple.
那他们就研究经文里面所提到所罗门圣殿的事情。
And they asked this question.
他们就问一个问题。
What would it take to rebuild Solomon's temple in that day?
就是那个时候用要花多少钱来重建所罗门的圣殿。
And so they did all the research that's in Scripture.
所以他们在圣经里面做了很多研究。
And according to the Illinois Society of Architects,
所以根据伊利诺伊州建筑师学会,
in 1925, to rebuild Solomon's temple in that day,
那就是当时要重建所罗门圣殿,
would cost $87 billion then.
要花费的是870亿美金。
Now, of course, an American dollar is worth about $8 Hong Kong.
当然你可以换算美金就是七块到八块钱的港币。
So you would have to multiply that amount by 8 times.
你要乘八倍就乘以那时候1925年的港币。
And so it would have been beyond anything we could imagine and how much it cost.
所以这个数字是超过我们想象的。
And you might wonder, where do you get all this information for research?
那你就会问啊，这个数字怎么得来的？
It comes in the Bible itself. In the early chapters of 1 Kings. And the early chapters of 2 Chronicles. It tells us a number of things. So here are some more facts about Solomon's temple. According to the historian Vallapardus. Just the talents of gold would be worth $34 billion in 1925. And then another historian, very famous historian Josephus, he valued the 140,000 talents of gold. That they alone back in 1925 would be worth over $1.8 billion.
就是在用1925年的币值来计算，那个金就是相当于18亿美金。
Now there's so much more detail I could give you, but I don't have the time for this.
那因为我没有很多时间，我还其实可以再跟大家分享很多这样的细节。
But the vessels of silver, there was actually more silver in the temple.
那在圣殿里面的银器比金器还多还重。
Then there even was gold.
那重很多。
That alone would be worth over $3 billion.
那银器也是有32亿的美金。
And here's another interesting fact.
那还有另外更有趣的事实。The
priests' vestments and the robes of the singers. Think of this.
就你去想象唱歌的人，他们的服装跟那个祭司袍。
Because they were adorned with jewelry.
因为上面都装饰着宝石。
They would be worth more than $10 million. American dollars.
那个是超过1000万美金的价值。
And then I discovered something very interesting.
那我又发现有个更有趣的。
Maybe you've never heard this.
可能你从来没想象过。
I found this in 2 Chronicles chapter 3.
我是从历代志下第3章找到的。
Each nail that was used in building the temple.
每一根钉子就是来建圣殿的钉子。
Was solid gold.
就是金金造的。
And it would weigh 1 pound.
一颗一口钉就是1磅。
Now I don't know what that is in grams or anything.
那一磅你可以换算成多少克？
But I know this about 1 pound.
但是我知道是1磅重。
1 pound has 16 ounces.
那一磅就是16盎司。
And today 1 ounce of gold is worth 1,300 American dollars.
那今天一盎司的金就是一千三百多美金。
So an entire pound,
所以一磅重的金金,
16 ounces,
16盎司,
would be worth 20,000 American dollars,
就是等于25,000多的美金,
or about 150,000 Hong Kong dollars for one nail.
就是等于16万多的港币,
and they had many nails.
那你知道圣殿里面很多口钉,
You say, why do I call this to your attention?
那我为什么要跟大家来分享这些呢?
I want you to know how beautiful this place was.
因为我要知道那个地方是多么的雄伟。
Now I know it took you a number of years to see this all accomplished.
我知道大家建这个殿也花了几年了，5年了。
Solomon's temple, it took 7 years and 6 months to build.
所罗门的圣殿是花了7年6个月建成的。
So you have to add all these facts.
所以你要加上这个连税。
You have to add all the workers.
你要加上所有的人工。
And you have to add what it costs to feed them.
然后你要加上就是所有这些人的粮食。
And so to the above, all that I've shared about the cost, you've got to add this.
所以我刚刚分享的，你还要加上这些的花费。
There were 10,000 men who cut down cedar trees.
那有10,000人是砍伐香柏的。
There were 70,000 bearers or carriers of burdens back and forth.
有7万人是来搬运东西的。
There were 80,000 hewers of stone or stone cutters.
或者有8万人是来切割石材的。
There were 3,850 managers or overseers.
那有3,850个是督工。
That's 163,500 workers.
加起来就是16万3千名工人。
And they all had to be fed.
那所有人都是要吃饭呢。
So all of these, what would it cost?
这样加起来总共的花费是多少？
In 1925, the cost would have been over $344 million.
所以是1925年的价值市值就是3亿4438万。
And there's just another factor too I could share.
那这还有另一个情况我要跟大家分享的。
In addition to the materials other than gold and silver and jewelry,
那除了这些金啊银啊宝石以外，
Just to purchase that would cost over $12 billion.
那就是要买这些物料也就是要127亿的美金。
And so the total value, as I stated, in 1925,
我把这些所有加起来就是用1925年的市值来计算，
was $87 billion.
就是说870亿的美金。
But that's 90 years ago.
但你知道这是19年前。
So I looked on the internet to see how much more would it cost today.
那我就在网上再查看现在，那1925年等于现在是多少钱？
It would be 12 times as much.
就是12倍的价值。
That is more than $1 trillion American dollars.
所以你这样乘上去就是超过1兆的美金。
Or perhaps 8 trillion Hong Kong dollars.
就是说8兆的港币。
We can't imagine that.
你想象到是怎么样，怎么巨大的数字吧？
And what is a trillion? How big is a trillion?
那到底1兆是多少，你知道吗？
If you had $1 million,
如果比如说你有100万，
we would need 1 million more people that each had $1 million to equal $1 trillion.
就是说有100万人，每人有100万， 那乘起来就是1兆。
That's 1 million.
就是100万个百万。
But here's what I want to say.
那现在我要跟大家讲的是，
That was how beautiful the temple was.
这个就是所罗门圣殿的华美。
The temple was extraordinary.
这个圣殿是超群赏的。
But At that moment, something was missing.
但是在那个时候却缺少了一个东西。
And I mean the moment when Solomon brought all the things into this beautiful temple.
当所罗门把所有的物件都带进这个圣殿里面。
We cannot imagine the gold.
我们没有办法想象是怎么样。
We cannot imagine the silver.
我们没有办法想象多么多少的金和银。
We could not imagine the jewelry.
我们也没有办法想象那个金银石宝石是多少。
But something was missing.
但是唯有一件事是缺
少。And when you read into the rest of the chapter,
等你继续从这章往下看，
you will see there are what I call four defining moments of dedicating the Temple of Solomon.
你就会看到有四个决定性的时刻是所罗门献殿的时候必须的。
And I refer to these as 611 defining moments because the same applies for us today.
然后我称之为四个六一一的决定性时刻，因为那时候是这样。我希望写应用到我们这里。
I will share these very quickly.
那我很快来分享。
So I can tell you a personal story.
然后我才给大家分享我的经历。
The first defining moment.
第一个决定性时刻。
The Ark of God's presence is brought in.
就是把神同在的约柜抬进来。
And chapter 5, verse 7 says this.
那第五章第七节这样说。
The priests then brought the Ark of the Lord's Covenant to its place in the inner sanctuary of the temple.
祭司将耶和华的约柜抬进内殿，就是至圣所。
This was the most holy place.
这个是就是至圣所。
And listen carefully, 611 church, listen carefully.
然后六一教会的弟兄姊妹要认真来听。
And they put it beneath the wings of the cherubim.
他们把约柜放在两个基路伯的翅膀底下。
Why is that significant?
为什么这句那么重要呢
？For 611 Church.
对六一来说，为什么这么重要呢
？Because that place right there.
因为这个地方
was literally the place where God's presence dwelt.
就是神同在居住之所。
And do you know what that place was called?
你知道那个地方叫什么吗
？It was called the mercy seat.
就是施恩座。
And that's what you call this place.
就是你们称这个地方的名字。
God has caused you to choose a name that represents His very holy presence.
神是要你们取这个名字，让这个地方成为他至圣之处。
And the second defining moment.
那第二个决定性时刻。
Priests are sanctified before God.
祭司在神面前自洁。
Verse 11.
第十一节。
The priests then withdrew from the holy place.
当时那里所有的祭司都出圣殿。
All the priests who were there had consecrated themselves regardless of their divisions.
在那里所有的祭司都自洁，并不分班次。
It did not matter what their gifts were or what their responsibilities were.
无论他们的恩赐是什么，无论他们的责任是什么。
They all were separated before God to be used by God as holy people.
都在神面前分别为圣，自洁，被神使用。
And then the third defining moment.
然后第三个决定性时刻。
The worshippers are all united in praise.
所有的敬拜者在神面前同心称颂。
This happened for all of us earlier in our worship.
今天早上在我们敬拜的时候，这事情就发生了。
Verse 13 says this.
那十三节这样讲。
The trumpeters and singers joined in unison as with one voice.
吹号的、唱歌的都一起发声，声合为一。
To give praise and thanks to the Lord.
赞美感谢耶和华。
Accompanied by trumpets, cymbals, and other instruments.
吹号、敲钹，用各样的乐器。
They raised their voices in praise to the Lord.
扬声赞美耶和华说。
They sang, "He is good."
耶和华本为善。
His love endures forever.
他的慈爱永远长存。
And then the main defining moment.
然后最重要的决定性时刻
，and the fourth defining moment,
就是第四个决定性时刻。
The temple is suddenly filled with a cloud of God's glory.
圣殿突然被神的荣耀云彩充满。
We see this in verse 13 and 14.
我们从十三节后半看到了。
Then the temple of the Lord was filled with a cloud.
那是耶和华的殿有云充满。
And the priests could not perform their service because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the temple of God.
甚至祭司不能站立供职，因为耶和华的荣光充满了神的殿。
And here's the lesson I learned in this.
这个就是我从中学到的功课。
I describe this as a simple observation.
我形容它是一个观察所得。
A lesson that I learned.
是一个我学到的功课。
And here it is.
就是这个。
God's glory.
当神的荣耀。
When it comes.
当它临到的时候。
Will push everything else out of the way.
它会把所有东西都推开。
God's glory is more important than anything else.
神的荣耀比任何东西都重要。
Because God's glory is His presence.
因为神的荣耀就是他的同在。
Sometimes we pray for the sick.
有时候我们会为病人祷告。
And we lay hands on many.
我们会为人按手。
Do you know something?
但是你知道一件事吗
When God's glory comes,
当神的荣耀临到
everybody could be healed at one time.
所有人马上会得医治
When God's glory comes, every need can be met.
当神的荣耀临到所有需要都被满足
So we want to make room for His glory.
所以我们需要为他的荣耀预备地方
And so I have a question.
所以我就问这个问题
Has God raised up the 611 church?
神是否兴起六一教会
To be an apostolic movement.
成为一个使徒性的运动
To serve the emerging generation in the last days.
来服侍末世新生世代。
What does God want to do through you for all of Hong Kong?
神要透过香港，透过六一做什么呢
？And then out into Asia.
那在亚洲做什么呢
？And then to the uttermost parts of the earth.
那去到全世界各地做什么呢
？Oh, He wants to do much more than we could imagine.
他要我们做的是超过我们想象的。
And so I have a simple answer.
所以我就得出一个很简单的答案。
I call it an apostolic principle for the vision of the 611 church.
我称之为六一教会意向的使徒性原则。
I'm going to tell the story in a minute.
等一下，我会分享一个故事。
Of how God showed me this principle.
神怎么让我明白这个原则
？But I'll give you the principle first.
但是我先来告诉大家这个原则。
No ministry, no church, no movement.
没有任何真正的使徒事工或运动。
Is ever truly apostolic?
就完全是真正的使徒性的。
Until its leadership first gives itself continually to prayer and the ministry of the word.
直到他们的领袖，所有的领袖先。持续的以专心以祈祷传道为事
Because we see that of the apostles.
因为我们在我们的使徒身上看到
and we see that in the early chapters of the book of Acts.
是在使徒行传的前几章我们都看到使徒是
这样做的 By Acts chapter 5, they were turning whole cities upside down.
那到使徒行传第五章使徒们把整个城市翻转了
At one occasion, one man was healed and 5,000 were saved because of it.
那有一次就一个人得救然后五千人信主
They went to every single household, every home in Jerusalem to proclaim Jesus.
他们把耶稣的名字传到耶路撒冷每一个家每一个人
That was their strategy.
这是他们的策略
They didn't want to miss anyone.
他们不想错过任何人
And so when we use the word of apostolic,
所以当我们用这个使徒性这个字
we really are saying this.
我们是在告诉人
We want a ministry that is like the apostles.
我们要做的事情，我们的事工要像使徒行传那样的事
工。We want to see the same miracles.
我们要看到同样的神迹。
Our God is still the same.
我们的神是同样的神。
And so in Acts chapter 6,
所以当来到使徒行传第六章。
Everything was growing so fast.
所有的事情发展得很快。
That the apostles couldn't do all the work.
使徒们没办法自己完成自己的事情。
So they raised up others.
所以他要兴起别人。
They called them deacons at first.
那开始的时候称这些被兴起的人为执事。
And then they made this decision.
然后他们做了一个决定。
And that's Acts chapter 6 verse 4.
就是来到使徒行传六章四节。
They said this.
他们这样说。
We the apostles.
我们使徒们。
Will give ourselves continually to prayer.
要专心持续。
And the ministry of the word.
和传道为事。
That's why, as a leader of our ministry,
所以作为一个事工的领袖
I know there's nothing more important I can do than be in prayer.
所以我知道没有事比传道比祈祷更重要。
And live in God's word.
那以祈祷和活在活出神的话。
And really create an atmosphere in our ministry for God to work.
然后让我们的事工里面有神的那个空间在工作。
And so I come to describe the story, the experience I had.
所以我接下来我要来形容我所经历的到底是什么。
More than 30 years ago.
那就超过30年前。
When God spoke to me about making room for His glory.
当神向我启示要为他荣耀预备地方。
I had been invited to a conference as one of the speakers.
我被邀请到一个特会里面做讲员。
There were perhaps 10 different speakers.
那除了我之外，还有十位的讲员。
And it was in a large convention center in America.
那个是在一个美国很超大的展览厅里面。
And these were spirit-filled university leaders.
这些所聚集的都是圣灵充满的青年领袖。
Young people from universities.
都是从大专学校
学员来的。There was 5,000 young people came from hundreds of universities.
从几百个学校里面招聚了5000个学生。
And I was invited to be one of the speakers to specifically speak on how to mobilize prayer on the campuses.
那是我是被邀请去特别要教导如何推动校园祷告。
And I was afraid even to go to this conference at first.
那开始的时候我是很怕去这样的特会。
Because I saw the different speakers.
因为我看到另外一些讲员的名字。
And all of them were very famous.
他们都是非常出名的讲员。
Most of them had their own television programs in America.
大部分他们都是在美国有自己的电视布道。
They were outstanding Bible teachers.
他们是非常超棒的圣经教师。
And I thought, how will I be able to do in that kind of an atmosphere?
那我就说，哇，这样的环境，我要讲什么？
But the leader of this movement of college students,
但是这个校园运动的那个领袖负责人，
he encouraged me.
他就
He said, more than anything else, we need more prayer on the university campuses.
比任何事更重要，我们是需要校园起来祷告。
And so, of the 4 or 5 days of the conference,
所以在特会里面四五天，
I was given 3 mornings
我有要我讲的是三个早上，
to speak 1 hour.
那每一个早上讲一个小时，
And I had 3 lessons.
然后我有三堂课。
And the first one of the lessons introduced the second lesson.
然后就第一堂课就是介绍第二堂课。
And then the third lesson was the most important.
然后我就讲第三堂课是最重要的。
Because it explained in detail what you could do when you go back to your college campus.
就是会解释很清楚你回到校园可以做什么。
And I tell you that detail for a reason.
然后我等一下就告诉大家我为什么这样讲。
Because there were other speakers.
因为有别的讲员。
And so I would start each of the first 3 mornings.
所以每一天的早上我是开始第一个讲。
With the first hour,
那就第一个小时是我的。
And they told me that I could not go beyond 1 hour.
然后他们就跟我们说，你一个小时准时要下来。
Because they have all these other speakers.
因为接下来还有别的讲员。
And they had one speaker after another.
那是第一个一个接一个的讲员排下去。
And one other thing I should tell you.
那另外一个我还要告诉大家的。
Is I was the only speaker that had workbooks, worksheets to
give out
to people. 我是
唯一一个讲员是派讲义的。
Because that's the way I often teach.
因为我经常是做这样的教导。
So people can write out the
所以别人就可以在这个讲义上可以写笔记，他们就不会忘记。
And then when they would go back home,
所以当他们回家之后，
they would have a plan.
他们就可以做一个计划。
And they asked me to do one other thing.
所以他们就跟我说再有一件事。
On the afternoons,
在下午的时候，
the day before each morning,
就是每一个早晨时段的前一个下午。
They asked if I would lead a prayer meeting.
他就请我去带一个祷告会。
In a ballroom at the main hotel by the convention center.
就是在那个酒店的 ballroom 里面，那个舞厅里面，我就带一个祷告会。
Now in the morning sessions,
早上的时候，
it was mandatory that everyone attend.
是每一个人必须出席的会议。
But the prayer meetings were optional.
那下午的祷告会是自由参加的。
So there were 5,000 young people in the main meetings.
所以早上的这个聚会是5,000个青年人。
In my first prayer meeting, there was about 100 people.
但是我第一个祷告会只有150人。
It was optional.
因为是自由参加。
I don't know why it is.
我不知道为什么。
But most people don't think they need to go to the prayer meeting.
很多人不认为他们需要去祷告会。
But the second day,
但是第二天，
I led and the number grew a little bit.
我就教了一些东西。
And each,
我就学了一些。
Each morning I was giving my teaching.
每天早上我就给我的教导。
And so after the second morning of teaching,
所以就第二天早上之后，
a few more got excited.
我有几个人就被我激励了。
And I don't remember the exact number.
我不知道具体有多少人。
But maybe it was about 200.
可能到200吧。
Maybe 250.
可能250。
And the next morning I was going to share my last teaching.
那第，因为明天我就要分享最后一堂了。
And during the prayer meeting,
那就是前一个下午的祷告会里面，
it was about 2 hours, maybe 3 hours long.
可能是2到3个小时的祷告会。
At one point,
那就到有某一刻，
I decided to just get on my face and pray.
那有一刻我就决定我要就是铺在地上，我要来祷告。
Everyone was just praying everywhere, kneeling in prayer.
每个人可能当时大家都跪下来呀，坐着祷告。
And I've always had a habit when I get on my face in prayer.
那我有一个的习惯，就是当我伏在地上祷告的时候，
to open up my Bible,
我就会打开我的圣经，
and lay my face in the pages of the Bible.
把我的脸伏在这个圣经上面。
And so I began to pray.
所以我就开始这样祷告。
I was laying on my face.
我就面伏于地这样祷告。
And after about a half hour,
但是大概 半小时之后
I started hearing weeping
我就开始听到哭泣的声音
and sobbing
开始抽搐的声音
and I didn't look up to see what it was
我没有去看发生什么事
but I knew the Holy Spirit was moving
但是我很知道圣灵在运行
and perhaps another hour passed
可能就是大概又过了一个小时
and even on my face
就是我即使面浮在我圣经上面
I looked at my watch
我就看看我的手表
and I realized that the prayer time was coming to an end
那我知道这个祷告会要结束了
and so I sat up
所以我就坐起来
and when I sat up and looked
当我坐起来一看
everyone in that room was flat on his or her face
每一个人在那个大厅里面所有人都面浮欲滴都在哭泣都在抽搐
except there was one brother
除了一位弟兄
it was humorous to me
对我来说是蛮滑稽的
because he wasn't flat on his face
他不是躺平在地上
They had chairs just like we have here in the auditorium
那个大堂里面有一些椅子像你们的椅子
They were not connected, they were just everywhere
椅子不是连起来的
And this one brother, he was a big brother big
那这位弟兄身材很大很高巨大
And he was laying over a chair, his whole body
他整个身体就瘫在那个椅子上面
He looked like a big fish
就看起来就像大鱼这样
It was just almost humorous But he was sobbing.
但是他在抽搐着。
And as I looked around the room,
我就周围看一下。
The Lord spoke to me.
神就告诉我。
And said, "This is what I want to do. I desire to do tomorrow."
他这样说，明天我要你做。
In that auditorium,
我希望你做在大堂里面就做这个。
It was a big domed auditorium.
那个就是一个坐五千人的那个整个大礼堂。
The Lord said, "I want to turn that place into a womb." Like a baby womb in the stomach, a womb of my glory.
他就说我要把那个大礼堂转化成一个母腹，就是要让 baby， 就是让我的荣耀生出来的母腹。
And I thought, oh God, how can you do that?
我说神啊，怎么做？
It's there's too many speakers. There's too much happening.
那个地方安排了很多讲员，很多的事情。
How could that be?
那怎么可能？
And I didn't think any more of it.
我就想不出。
Until I went to sleep that night.
直到晚上我回去睡觉。
Or I should say, I tried to go to sleep.
或应该这样说，我很想努力去睡。
My wife was with me, and she fell asleep quickly.
那我师母在我身边，她很快睡着了。
And I just laid there.
我就躺在床上。
I couldn't sleep.
我没办法睡觉。
I tried to sleep.
我很想入睡。
Have you heard about counting sheep to go to sleep?
大家明白吗？数一只羊、两只羊这样去睡觉吗？
I tried to count blessings and it didn't work.
那我也试了，尝试数算那个祝福，也不行。
Once I heard that when you go into deep sleep, your eyes have rapid movement.
那我有听过人说，当你进入熟睡的时候，你的眼皮会跳动。
So I'm laying there.
所以我就躺在那边。
And I think, oh, I'm going to try moving my eyes really fast.
我就想我要自己来动我的眼皮好入睡。
And nothing happened.
还是不行。
And all of a sudden,
突然之间
I heard God speak.
我听到神说话了。
He said simply this.
他就是简单的一句。
Make room for my glory.
为我的荣耀预备地方。
And at first I said, God, is that you?
神是你吗？
Like young Samuel hearing God speak.
就好像小小的撒母耳听到神说话。
And I said, God, is that you? And he said, yes.
神是你讲话吗？
And he said, and I said, well, what do I do?
那我就问神，那我要做什么？
And he did not answer that.
他没有回答，
telling me what to do.
他没有告诉我做什么。
He just said,
他就是说，
make room for my glory.
为我的荣耀预备地方。
And I said, well, how, God? What do you want me to do?
我说神，那你到底要我做什么？
And he would not answer that.
他就是不回答。
I heard it again. Make room for my glory.
我再次听到为我的荣耀预备地方。
Will you make room for my glory?
你要为我的荣耀预备地方吗？
And I said again, How, Lord?
我说怎么样做？
And I think I counted actually 10 times. I heard this.
我就是数了，神这样跟我讲了超过十遍。
And finally, I said this.
最后我就说
，Yes, Lord.
神，我要。
I don't know what you want me to do.
我不知道你要我为你做什么。
But I will make room for your glory.
但是我愿意为你的荣耀预备地方。
I didn't know what I was to do.
那我真的不知道要做什么。
And I said, Lord, what do you want me to do?
我就说神，你到底要我
做什么？ And he spoke further.
然后他就继续讲。
He said, Have you ever heard better Bible teaching of Bible teachers in your life?
你的生命中从来遇到最好的那个圣经教师，最好的圣经教导吗？
No, Lord, I've never heard better teaching.
我从来没有听过比昨天更好的。
And then he said, Have you ever seen more excitement in the way the dancers danced?
他说你见到过比这里更有更让人兴奋的舞蹈吗？
They waved their banners.
你知道在聚会里面他们就挥起舞蹈。
But everything was programmed by the minute.
但是每一个特会都是安排好的。
And each speaker would come and just give his message.
每一个讲员上到台上讲信息，然后他们就跳舞
，and maybe sing one song，
然后可能唱一首歌
，and then they would another speaker would come，
然后另一个讲员再上来讲
，and so the Lord was saying， Have you ever seen anything that has been more organized better？
神说你见过有这么比这个更有系统、更有组织的事情吗
？Lord， it seems they're so disciplined。
我说哎，他们真的很有纪律。
And the Lord said， There's only one thing。
那神就跟我说，只有一件事。
No one has made room for my glory.
这里没有一个人为我荣耀预备地方。
And then he said,
然后他就说
Would you make room for my glory?
你愿意为我的荣耀预备地方吗？
And then I said, But how, Lord?
然后我就说我愿意，但是要怎么做？
And then he spoke.
然后
he said, When you get up to give your final lesson,
当你明天起来讲最后一堂的时候
I don't want you to give your lesson.
我不想你讲任何事。
I said, well, what do you want me to do?
那你要我做什么？我就问。
He said, I want you to do nothing.
我要你做，我要你不做。
I want you to walk to the pulpit and just do nothing.
我想你上到台上，什么都不做。
Wait for me to do what I desire to do.
等我做我要做的。
I said, Lord, I said,
我说神。
Oh God.
我说神啊。
Are you aware?
你知道吗？
That it's my final lesson.
这个是我最后要讲的一堂课。
And it's the most important lesson.
也是我要讲最重要的一堂课。
What a foolish question to say, "Are you aware, God?"
这个是多么愚蠢的问题，这样问神，你知道吗？
He said, "I know that."
神当然说我知道。
But my glory can accomplish far more.
但是我的荣耀可以成就更伟大的事。
In just a few moments.
就是几刻之后。
Than anything you could say.
所有你比你所说的更重要。
Well, I did not sleep the whole night.
哇，那天晚上我没办法。
My wife was fast asleep.
我太太熟很熟睡。
She apparently didn't care.
所以因为她是不用管的。
Because she didn't know.
是因为她也不知道发生什么事。
So I was already up.
所以我就一早就起来了。
I took my shower.
我就洗个澡。
I was all dressed to speak.
所有穿好了要去讲课。
I was sitting on a couch.
我已经坐在沙发上。
And when my wife saw me,
那我师母看到我
she knew something was wrong.
她知道一定有事情发生
And she came and sat beside me.
然后她就来坐在我身边
And she said, "Honey, what's wrong?"
Honey, 什么事啊
I said, "God has told me to do something this morning, and I don't know how to do it."
我说神今天早上要我做一件事，但是我不知道怎么做
And I want to be obedient.
那我很想顺服神
And she had this frightened look on her face.
那她脸上就有一个很惊吓的表情
What does God want him to do?
那神要你做什么
I hope God doesn't want him to dance up and down the aisles.
我希望神没有叫你去
Or do something foolish, I don't know.
或者一些很愚蠢的
But she said, what does he want you to do?
她说神到底要你做什么
And I said, he wants me to do nothing.
她要我什么都不做
And she looked at me.
她就望着我
She said, what do you mean nothing?
他说什么？什么叫什么都不做
？He doesn't want me to teach.
他不要我教导。
He just wants me to go stand in front of them.
他就是叫我站在所有人面前。
And do nothing.
什么都不做。
She said, "You can't just do nothing."
你不可能什么都不做吧
？And I said, "I know."
我说我知道啊。
That's my problem.
这就是我的问题啊。
I don't know how to do nothing.
我真的不知道如何什么都不做。
I have never done nothing.
因为我从来就没有试过什
么都不做。I've always done something.
我从来就是要做一些事。
And then it gets much worse. Much worse.
就是最就越来越糟
了。When it's my time to speak,
当我要上去讲的时候
the leader of the whole group,
那整个团队的领袖
said, "Now Brother Dick is coming to give his final lesson."
就是说 Brother Dick 要上来给大家讲最后一堂课。
It's the most important lesson on prayer you'll ever hear.
这一堂是关于祷告最重要的一堂课。
Ushers, he said, "Be sure everybody has a workbook."
招待一定要把讲义派给每个人。
Give everybody a workbook. Make sure they all have one.
每个人都要有讲义。
How many don't have one? Raise your hands.
谁没有讲义的，请举手。
And I knew I was going to do nothing.
但我心里面知道我不可能做任何事。
And then it came my time to step up.
那是时候我要站到台上。
Now I am out of my time to tell you this whole story.
那我没有时间再跟大家讲了。
Except to conclude.
但是要最后跟你大家分享。
And all I can tell you is this.
我要跟大家讲的就是。
As I stood there.
当我站在那里。
Over the next few minutes.
就是几分钟之后。
The presence of God came into that place.
神的同在充满那个地方。
And I still remember distinctly.
我仍然记得那一幕。
Not even knowing what to do.And looking up,
我就看着
into one part of this large auditorium,
就是在这个大堂的最角落那里
and young people were starting to get up out of their chairs.
年轻人开始从座位上站起来
and they went into the aisles and they laid on their face.
所有去到那个走道里面面伏于地
they were laying under the auditorium seats.
就是在那个椅子底下也面伏于地
Within 5 to 10 minutes.Everyone was on his face.
所有大堂所有五千个到处都是
They just began to weep before the Lord.
他们开始就在神面前哭泣
And it was a sound I've never heard before.
那个声音我是以前从来没有听过的声音
And it went on for almost an hour.
那继续这样持续一小时
Or more.
可能长过一小时
But when I looked at my watch,
但是当我看看我手表
my hour was up.
我的一小时已经到了。
And another speaker was to come.
那下一个讲员要上台了。
So I turned to find the leader.
所以我就起来要找那个负责人。
To say you can come now.
我就说你现在是你可以上来。
And you can go on with the program.
你可以继续你的程序。
But I couldn't find the leader.
但是我找不到那个负责人。
And I looked.
然后我再看一下。
And I looked.
我再看。
And then I found him.
然后我就找到他。
He was under the piano.
他是在那个钢琴底下
on his face, just sobbing.
他也是面浮于地在那边哭泣
I just said, Lord, I don't know what to do.
我是说主啊我不知道要做什么
So I went and got on my face.
所以我也继续面浮于地
And do you know what?
那你知道吗
There, Nothing else ever happened in the program that day.
那一天所有的程序都被取消了
The only thing that happened
唯有一件事发生
was people crying out to God.
就是大家都一起在神面前哭求哭泣
And that was 30 years ago.
那个是在三十年前发生的事。
I still encounter young people, or now they're older.
到今天，那我仍然看到这些青年人现在已经年纪大了。跟我说
，I was there that day.
那天我在场。
And something was born in my life.
就是那天我生命中生出一个事情。
That has followed through my ministry.
就是从一直持续让我在我施工里面。
Even this one leader.
就是这一个负责人
went on to disciple thousands and thousands of young people in Russia.
他开始去到欧洲，去到那个苏联，去那边门训，训练了几千几千的门徒。
And I believe it was a river of God's glory that began to flow.
我相信是神的河流在那边涌流。
So I simply conclude by this.
所以我要做一个总结。
When I came.Into the meeting yesterday first.
昨天是第一次
And then today.
今天是第二次
I knew I was in a church that's making room for God's glory.
我知道我到了一个教会是为神的荣耀预备地方的
Do not stop.
不要停在这里
And then one final thing.
然后最后一句话
We in our own lives need to make room for God's glory every day.
每一天在我们生命里面，我们需要为神预备地方。
Do you set aside at least an hour just to worship and praise God?
你有没有至少把一个小时分别出来来敬拜、来祷告
？And to pray for others.
要为别人祷告。
Jesus said, "Could you not watch with me even 1 hour?"
耶稣说：“你不可以为我警醒一刻钟吗？”
This was a decision I made maybe 40 years ago.
这个就是我四十年前做的决定。
To at least spend that much time.
就至少有这样的时间。
In the presence of the Lord.
停留在神的同在里面。
And I learned this lesson.
然后我学到这个功课。
The more I make room for God's glory.
我越多为神的荣耀预备地方。
And the more our ministry makes room for God's glory.
那我们的事工就越让神有空间工作。
The more God does all over the world.
那神就可以在世界各地做更大的工作。
And so I just say hallelujah.
所以我就说 hallelujah.
For the new beginning.
为着我们新的开始。
That is happening now in 611 Church.
就是在611教会发生的。
Can you say hallelujah?
我们一起来说 hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
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 Hallelujah! 谢谢 Dr. Dick Eastman.
We thank you for the sharing of Dr. Dick Eastman.
我今天才知道
Only till today I know.
我错了13年了
I've been making a mistake for the past 13 years.
13年前，当我来香港的时候，神给我的感动就是要经营神的同在。
When I came here 13 years ago, God prompted me. My purpose here is to make room for Him.
每一个的聚会都是经营神的同在。
Every meeting here is to host His presence.
相对的意义就是说，为神预备荣耀的地方。
The same meaning.
装载他的荣耀。
Is to make room for His glory, to carry His glory.
但是过去十三年呢？
But in the past 13 years,
我都在做很多事情来经营神的同在。
I've been doing many things myself. I've been doing a lot of things trying to host His presence.
今天多特地告诉我们，经营神同在，神跟他讲是 you do nothing.
Dr. Dick has told him that host His presence is to do nothing.
什么都不用做。
Do nothing of ourselves.
我奉耶稣的名祝福我们每一位弟兄姐妹。
In the name of Jesus, I bless every brother and sister.
愿你成为一个永恒的敬拜者。
May you be an eternal worshipper.
你的敬拜被神悦纳。
Your worship is acceptable to God.
你每时每刻在不同地方的敬拜都满有恩膏。
Wherever and whenever you worship God is anointed.
愿你一生都成为敬拜的人。
May your whole life be a life of worship.
愿当你敬拜的时候，神就降临。
Because when you worship Him, He comes to you.
小组长们，我奉主的名祝福你。
All the cell leaders, in the name of Jesus,
每一个小组都充满神的荣耀。
Every cell group is filled with the glory of God.
充满你的家。
Fill in your home.
每一位弟兄姐妹，我奉耶稣的名祝福你。
In every brothers and sisters, in the name of Jesus, I bless you.
凡你所到之处，
wherever you go,
都带来神的荣耀。
You bring the glory of God with you.
平安、喜乐、能力与你同在。
The peace, joy, and strength is with you.
凡你所做的，
whatever you do,
都蒙神赐福。
Is acceptable, is pleased by
the Lord. 凡你口中所有的祷告，神都垂听。
And your prayer is answered by God.
神祝福你的一切。
May the Lord bless all you have.
你的家，你的工作。
Your house, your family, your work.
你的健康。
Your health.
你的下一代，这一代，上一代。
Your descendants, your next generation and the next generation.
奉耶稣的名祝福你。
In the name of Jesus, I bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, 把荣耀归给神。
All glory to God.